Welcome to the second lecture of Basic Machinery Fundamentals, and this is second and probably the last lecture of physics. And after this, we're gonna go to the big picture part where you are gonna see some physics, but it also consists of the basic ideas of induction motor. Okay, in this lecture, we're gonna talk about how a current-carrying loop behaves in a stationary magnetic fields, and at the end of this video, we're gonna see that there is a torque eventually induced in that current carrying loop. But before that, I also want to say that a current carrying loop creates a magnetic field itself. We can find the direction of the magnetic field by right hand rule. You just curl your hand in the direction of the current flow and your thumb will point in the direction of the magnetic field. So we will basically see how the magnetic field react in this video. Alright, so let's consider this case. This is a loop, a rectangular loop like this, and the magnetic field is in the horizontal direction, and we are considering that our loop is in some random orientation with respect to our magnetic field. Now we're gonna consider a vector, a perpendicular, which has the magnitude of the area of the loop, and we're gonna consider the direction of the direction of a perpendicular in the direction of magnetic field produced by the loop. Remember, there are two magnetic fields, and here we are considering the magnetic field produced by the loop, not the stationary one. That's the details of a perpendicular. And to provide the equation of the torque induced in this loop, we first have to know what is the force on a wire, current carrying wire. And the force on a current carrying wire is simply found out by I L cross B, where L is in the direction of the current flow. We're gonna use that rule in this scenario and find out how the forces are oriented. Alright, so this is the way the current carrying loop is oriented, and this is the magnetic field according to your picture, right? So you see, in this segment, current is going in the upward direction and magnetic field is in this way. So if you use your right hand, so that means you go from this way there, so force will be in this direction, and that's what I'm going to denote here. Alright, and in this segment, the L vector is simply on the opposite direction, B vector remains the same, so cross product will simply reverse this direction. Alright, and in the top segment, the current is going in this way, and remember, magnetic field is in this direction. So if you go from L to B, that means the cross product will point in the upward direction, and that's what I'm going to denote here. And in the downward segment, the L vector simply reverses its direction, so the cross product will also reverse its direction. Right, we don't have to do calculation on here. So that's what all the forces are, and I'm going to denote this force as F. This is F1, this is F2, this is F3, this is F4. Alright, before evaluating what's the value of this force, let me just say two things. First of all, these two forces, F2 and F4, they are on the same line as the center of mass of this rectangular body, so they will not produce any torque. Right, that's what it said, that according to the rotational mechanics, they have no momentum, meaning they have no perpendicular distance from the center of mass to the action of force. So F2 and F4 will not produce any torque. The only two things producing torque will be F1 and F3. Alright, and what's the magnitude of F1 and F3? To evaluate that, we need width and length. We need to define the width and length, and the width, that means these segments are defined as B, and the length is defined as A. Remember, it's the rectangular loop we're considering. Alright, then this force, what's the magnitude of this force is going to be? Remember how we found out this force? This force is always, this force was found out by doing cross product on L cross B, and remember, L was in this direction and B was in this direction, and as they're orthogonal, the sine product, the sine theta is already going to give us 1, so the magnitude can be easily said to be I L B. Alright, and what's L in here? Here the L is simply the width, so it's going to be I B B, and the magnitude of F3 is also going to remain the same, so it's going to be IBB also. Alright, now we are all ready to find out torque. Okay, so here it is, that torque is simply a force into perpendicular distance from center of mass to action of force. Alright, so here are two forces, F1, F3. This is the side view we are considering, and this is the center of mass. And what are the angles that are given to us? Angles given to us are the angle between the magnetic field and a perpendicular, and is given that the angle is theta. Alright, how are you gonna use that to find the torque? Alright, try to notice that a perpendicular is perpendicular to this line. Alright, and B vector is perpendicular to our force, because obviously the cross product is going to be perpendicular to all the vectors, which is the to the vectors that we crossed. Alright, so we know the angle between a perpendicular and B, and we want to know the angle between the perpendicular of this vector and the perpendicular of this vector. And we know that if the angle between two vectors are known, then the angle between their orthogonals are also going to be known, and it's going to be the same theta. So with this information, we can say that the angle between F1 and the angle between the body is also going to be theta. And now we're all ready to find out the perpendicular distance. Remember, this total thing was a, if you try to notice from this picture, this was the side view and this is totally a. From center of mass point of view, this is this portion is going to be a by 2 and this portion is going to be a by 2. This is theta, and we want to find out this portion and this portion. And if you use trigonometry a little bit, they are going to force into a by 2 sine theta, and there is another, that means this force is F1 and this force is F3 into a by 2 sine theta. That's the perpendicular distance we are considering. Alright, now if we have simply used the magnitude of F1 and F3 right now, we are all in our way. We have derived before F1 and F3 magnitude are IBB and A by 2 sine theta plus IBB A by 2 sine theta, and we need to add them. So if we add them, it becomes IABB sine theta. And what is AB? AB is the area which is equal to the magnitude of a perpendicular, right? So this is going to be IA perpendicular B sine theta. Now we want to inject in this equation the magnetic field that the loop produces. Alright? Now what's the magnetic field of the loop? We know that it's going to be mu I over some parameter g that depends on how your geometry is. It's 2r for a circle, it's 2a for a rectangle, and that's all. And we want to inject this B loop in this equation. Alright, for some reasons we're gonna see later why. Now what is this theta? This theta is the angle between a perpendicular and B. So if we simply put the value of I from these equations, what is going to happen? This, if we replace it, that's going to become, if substitute it, that's going to become B loop G over mu A perpendicular. This B is the stationary, so we're going to call this BS and sine. Remember, A perpendicular and B loop are in the same direction. That's how we have defined them. So it's going to be B loop angle B, because they are in the same direction, a perpendicular and B loop. So we can as also say that the angle is between B loop and B. Alright, so after this, if we make some simplification, we are gonna call this whole portion except the B loop some constant K. So it becomes K B loop times BS sine of angle between B loop and BS. And what the equation looks like, it is begging to do a cross product, right? And that's what we're going to do now. In the vector notation, the vector tau is equals to kappa, some constants, times vector product of V loop and BS vector. Alright, and that's the equation we're searching for. Alright, usually for induction motor, B loop becomes B rotor and BS becomes BS stator. But the idea is, this is how exactly two magnetic fields react. And what's the interpretation of this cross product? The interpretation of this cross product is that current carrying loop always wants to align itself in the direction with the stationary magnetic field. Try to see this, that the torque is in the direction from B loop to B. That means the torque is in this direction, because that is B loop and that is B. So if we use our right hand, the torque is in going inward to the pace. And if the torque is going inward to the pace, what will be the rotation? The rotation will be in the clockwise direction, right? And if the rotation is clockwise, that means that this a perpendicular will is trying to match with the B field, a stationary magnetic field. And that's what we say, the interpretation, the big interpretation. This is the most phenomenal thing, that when two magnetic fields interact, they want to align themselves in the same direction. And that's all for today.